Hello, Pythoneer. You know why you're here, so let's get right into it. Here's how to get started with the xAI API to use Grok in Python. We first head over to x.ai/API to get a short overview. At the top, we see the info that xAI opened their public beta to the Grok beta model in the API. In the Quick Start section, we get the info that we can use the OpenAI and Anthropic SDKs to use the API. Then we see a very nice goodie. We devs get a $25 free credit until the end of the year 2024 to test out the API. And then we can create an account if you don't have one yet and grab an API key. The easiest way, I see here, is to log in with your X account if you have one. Just follow the steps I show here, or use your preferred way of authentication. We have to agree the terms and that we are above 18, and then we are set up. When we enter the page the first time, we get guided to generate our first API key we could directly use. Copy the key and hold it so we can paste it in the code later. Before we get into coding, here's some additional information on the dashboard. On the left menu on the key symbol, you can access all your current API keys. On the main page, we see that we got a free credit and the info on how much credit is left. Then we have buttons to create a new API key, invite your team, set up the billing, and view the models, which I want to show next. Currently, we have two new beta models, a text-to-text and a vision model. The prices shown here might be per million tokens, but I don't see an explicit info. Let me know in the comments if you have more details on this. Then we can get over to the docs, where we can grab a boilerplate code. Here we first see a great overview of what the models are capable and how the API works. Please check it out by yourself. And then jump direct to the API reference tab in the left top or right. I will show you the integration with the OpenAI SDK. Therefore, I choose the OpenAI SDK under the Integrations tab. Then we look for the Python code, copy it, and get finally over to the code editor. We paste the code here and have to do just a few small adjustments to get the first run done. First, we need to install the OpenAI library using the command pip install OpenAI. Then you have to add your API key int to xAI API key variable. And then we can do our first run with the pre-delivered message. And that's it, basically. If you want to know more about the OpenAI SDK, I suggest you to check out my linked video here at the top, or check out the description for more detailed videos. And if you liked this video so far, please consider giving it a like and subscribe. To get just the content from the response, we have to add the content attribute after the message in the print. When we run this again, the output is more clear. Before we end this video, here a brief overview on the inputs. First, we have the model we want to ask. In the message, we have in this example two text inputs. The first one is the general system prompt that tells the model how to act in general, like defining a style of response. The second one is the user input, where you can ask your question. One of the main benefits from the Grok model is that it has access to the Twitter data, which is like having real-time data and news, even faster than some newspapers and so on. But what comes now disappoints me a bit and disproves that benefit, at least on these beta models. I asked the model to tell me the current Python news, and the response is about older, outdated news. I hope we get more updated versions soon. Therefore, you should stay tuned. And that's it. Let us know in the comments what you think about these models. Is Elon doing great for us, or is he just hunting for a bigger slice of the AI pie? And before you go, let me thank you for watching so far. I hope you enjoyed this video. I am working hard on getting better quality videos produced. Furthermore, I hope I see you in the next one.